Good morning. I'm glad you made it. Good for you. I know it's not easy. Let's get started. This is Sober Dope Fix Series 3, Day 5. All right, so let's get this going. Let's take 1 minute. If prayer is your thing, now's a good time to say a prayer. Check in with yourself. See how you're feeling. Notice your thoughts, your emotions and feelings. Notice your body sensations. Just take an awareness and also set your intention for 60 seconds. Here we go. Please stand up. Notice how you feel. I feel a little bit shitty this morning. I myself am pretty tired, I must say. So if you're feeling tired, you're in good company. I'm sure a lot of us are. That's okay. Our shitty feelings can come along for the ride and hopefully they'll start to fade a little bit into the back. I'm gonna set the timer for 10 minutes. We're gonna do a 10 minute primer to help get our body going. Today, this moment is the beginning of the rest of our life. Think about your intention. Think about what your goal is. For 10 minutes, here we go. Take a moment and stand at ease and just notice how you feel in relationship to gravity. Take a deep breath. Exhale. Take another deep breath. Good. Exhale. Hands up for breath of fire. The start of the engines. Starting our engines. Ready, set, and go. Good. Breathe deep. Walk forward a little bit. Walk backwards. Start to swing your arms. The shirt may be a little too tight for me today, but that's all right. I'm going to work it out. Just notice how you feel, moving your head around, bringing your legs up to the body. Just starting to move it. Just starting to move it, baby. Hands up, ready, set, and go. Good. Breathe deep. Good. Exhale. Notice how you're feeling continually, moving your arms around, twisting your body a little bit, not too hard. Just get your body right and into the morning. Hands up, last time. Ready, set, and go. Good, breathe deep. Exhale, hands out to the side, fingertips back towards your ears, palms pushing out, knees slightly bent, and push. Take a deep breath. Shoulders up to the ears, and exhale, relax. One more time, shoulders up, breathe in deep, and relax. Palms together, thumbs to your sternum. See if you can feel your heart rate. Take a minute to notice. Notice where your tension is in your body. Notice where your thoughts are. Notice if you're addicted to complaining in your own mind. And come back to the present. Get back in your body. Notice how you're feeling. Take a deep breath. Palms to your ears. Up on your toes. Hands to the sky. Look at the sky. Look up to the ceiling. Up, up, up. Up on your toes. This is important. Stay as high as you can. Moving your hands around like this. twinkling your fingers, flicking your hands out like that, spreading your fingers, palms to the ceiling, raising the roof, top of the hands to the ceiling. Good. Take a deep breath and come down on your heels, bending from the waist, bending your knees, fingertips on the ground. All weight on your heels, bending your knees, fingertips on the ground. Relax. Relax your head, relax your neck, relax your shoulders. This is a relaxation exercise. Relax your tongue. Relax the top of your head. Relax the area behind your eyes. Breathe deep 2 times. Each time sinking closer to the ground, allowing your head to pull down towards the ground, elongating your spine. Staying in that position, fingertips on the ground, all weight in your heels, and begin to straighten your legs and take 2 breaths. This is a great stretch for your calves. If you've been using any toxins or putting any toxins in your bodies, chances are you have a lot of toxins in your calves. As I've said before, your calves are your lowest, largest muscle group. They hold a lot of toxins. Keep breathing, stretching your calves. Good. Put your hands flat on the ground, bending your knees. Walking your hands forward, getting ready for a plank. Ready? On your marks, get set, and go. Forearms and toes. Nothing else touching the ground. Bring your belly button back up to your spine. Flexing your thighs and your glutes. Breathing. We've talked a lot about how thoughts become patterns, ruminations, ingrained thoughts. Addictions come in many shapes and many sizes. Thoughts can become very addictive. We've often talked about how anger can be addictive, even our depressions. And I'm not saying there's any fault or anyone's bad or wrong for it, but we have to recognize it for what it is. If you need to take a break, come down on your knees and then come back and join us immediately. Recognizing how we can become addicted to complaining. That is part of our negativity bias. If you've done any traveling, you know how much suffering there can be in the world. And sometimes we complain because we're not able to address and engage the gratitude that we feel. We're not used to it. We spend so much time complaining, it's out of our comfort zone to acknowledge the good fortune that we have. Just so you know, we only have about 20 seconds left of this plank. So learning to recognize the good fortune that we have, learning to enjoy it, learning to try to expand and build on that good fortune, is a very healthy thing. So watching where we get stuck in our ruminations, how we become addicted to complaining. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Come down on your knees. Whew, that was a good one. Come down on your knees, sitting up straight. Put your hands on your waist. Look up at the sky, slight back bend, 2 deep breaths. Breathe. Come back to center, create a triangle. Put your hands flat on the ground, put your forehead in there, and breathe twice into your lower back. Good. And coming to all fours, put your feet back to downward dog. And let's just stay here for a moment, downward dog. Trying to bring your heels down to the ground, trying to keep a flat back. I'm not quite a good yoga guy, but do the best we can. Keep breathing. And then on an inhale, come to upward facing dog. And exhale back to downward facing dog. Walk our hands forward. All weight on your heels, fingertips on the ground. Good. Knees slightly bent. Now bending your legs, straightening your legs, stretching your calves, and then bending your knees, hands up into chair pose. Coming into chair pose, knees bent. All weight in your heels for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. In forward bend, straightening your legs. Good. Breathe. And one more time into chair pose, sitting back. All weight into your heels for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stand up straight. Keep your arms out. And 10 squats. We're doing a lot of good thigh work. Ready, set, and go. 1, 2, 3. Don't let your knees go over your toes. Stick your booty out. 8, 9, and 10. Good. Stretch out your feet. Kick out your legs. Move your hips. Shake your shoulders. Shake your arms. Shake your face. And 20 jumping jacks. Ready, set, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good. Breathe deep. Good. Excellent. Take a deep breath. Exhale, hands out to the side, fingertips back towards your ears. Palms pushing out. Take a deep breath. Exhale, palms together, thumbs to your sternum. See if you can feel your heart rate. Good. That was exactly 10 minutes. Please have a seat. Let's get ready for the two-wheel practice. Time to focus our mind, focus our brain. For 180 seconds. Coming into posture. Knees over your ankles, thighs parallel to the ground, your body's upright, shoulder blades slightly back. Ears over your shoulders, jaws parallel to the ground, teeth are not touching, lips are slightly parted. Tip of the tongue to the roof of the mouth. Bridge of your nose is wide and spacious, eyes are closed or looking down at a 45 degree angle. By now you know the posture, you know the breathing technique, you know what to do with the points of tension. All right, here we go. 180 seconds, you're either focused or you're practicing the technique. Here we go. Please get into posture and begin. No matter how distracted you get, come back to your focus. Stop making excuses. Over and over, come back to your focus. how distracted you get over and over. For these 3 minutes, come back to your focus. Over and over. Good. Take a deep breath. Notice the thoughts that distracted you. Come to push-up position. I'm going to re-energize the body. Pay close attention to your ability to focus your mind. Your ability to focus your mind is one of the most important skills you will have in your life, period. Ready for 20 push-ups? On your marks. Get set and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Excellent. Please pull out your journal. Please make sure you put the date on top of the journal. If for this section, you got 5 minutes. You have 5 minutes to write. Please be sure to fill it all out completely. Be sure to put the date. For 5 minutes, please begin. First part of the journal. What are you grateful for? What are your fears? Let's go. Let's get to know yourself. Time to be honest. Time to get real. Make sure you try to get through all of this. Put in your anxiety scale. All you got to do is circle a number or write out your number. Make sure you're writing your signs of emotional and mental relapse. What are you going to do about it? Where are you lacking in self-care? As we know it, just a reminder, emotional relapse, lack of self-care. Are you eating enough? Are you sleeping enough? Are you exercising? Are you drinking enough water? Are you irritable most of the time? Those are signs of emotional relapse, and you got to talk to someone about it. If that's what you're seeing in yourself, signs of emotional relapse, you got to talk to somebody about it. Same with mental relapse. Have you been doing things that reflect mental relapse? Are you thinking a lot about your substances, or if you're dealing with emotional sobriety, are you having a lot of negative thoughts? Are you complaining a lot, like we were talking before? There's an irritability to your ruminations. Those are signs of mental relapse. Okay? You have to address them. You have to be honest with yourself. If you're seeking emotional sobriety, if you're seeking substance sobriety, you have to be able to check with these things every day if you're wanting to really stay sober long term. Okay? Maybe after a few years and you're good, okay. Maybe you can lax up a little bit. All right, we have only a few seconds left of this. Make sure you filled out pretty much all of this. Actually, make sure you filled out all of this and you've written in response to all of this. If you need to push pause, of course, you can always do that. All right, from wherever you are, that's 5 minutes. Please sit up straight. Please do sit up straight. We're going to do a quick little energizing practice real quick with your hands up. Ready, set, and go. Good. Take a deep breath. All right, we're almost done. Today is the question of the day, and today is, for 3 minutes, please begin. Find the question of the day. Hopefully you're doing this sequentially, and begin. Write out as much as you can. Be honest with yourself for 180 seconds. All right? What are 3 things you did yesterday that are forms of self-care? That's a good question for today. All right. Not too hard. But good to reflect on. Let's see. Uh-huh. And if you can, say why those things are self-care for you. Why is that important for you? All right. I finished early with mine, so I'm going to do some extra stretching and exercising. I got a minute left. Feel free, if you finished early, to join me. Let's see here. I'm gonna do a stretch. I have a herniated disc, so I get sciatica. So I'm gonna do this little stretch right here, where I take one foot, I put my ankle on my knee, or right on my thigh, and then I reach through, and I grab my knee or my shin. Then I lay back flat down, and I bring that knee towards my body. I pull my shin towards me. It's a great glute stretch. This is good for me and my sciatic stuff. I was actually hit by a car several years ago while I was sitting in a parked car. Turned out it was a drunk driver. I went to the hospital. He fled the scene, never to be seen again in a stolen car. And that was that. So then I reached through to keep it balanced, grab the other shin, and that's our 3 minutes. Excellent. Everybody, please stand. Please stand. Congratulations, you've done an entire morning routine. I hope you feel much better. Notice how you feel. Just notice how you feel. Take a deep breath in. Exhale. Out. One more deep breath in. Exhale. One last deep breath. Exhale, hands out to the side, fingertips back towards your ears, pushing out. Deep breath in. Exhale, palms together, thumbs to your sternum. See if you can feel your heart rate. Just take a moment and review your gratitude list. Try to stay a little more grateful today. See what happens. Take a moment and review your goals for the day. What are you trying to do today? Take another moment and please review, what are your signs of relapse? What are your signs of emotional and mental relapse? And what are you going to do about it? Are you going to talk to someone? What kind of action are you going to take? Et cetera, et cetera. All right. Fantastic job. I'm glad you showed up. I wish you a great day. I'll see you tomorrow. Take care.